Students, in this video we will learn about the derivation of Ohm's law. In the previous video we had understood about the concept of Ohm's law. If you did not watch that video, watch the video and then you will get the derivation of Ohm's law properly. Now consider about the conductor of length L and the cross sectional area A. Here potential difference V is applied across the terminals. This is connected to the positive terminal of the battery. That's why that end, in that end here positive potential is developed. This is connected to the negative terminal. That's why here in that end here negative potential will be developed. Due to the potential difference here electric field is produced. That is E. So when applied potential V is there and electric field is E, then the relation between electric field and potential is V, E equal V upon L. Sorry, here V upon L. Okay. Now this is the electric relation between potential difference and electric field. Okay. This is the positive phase. Okay. Because this is the positive phase. Here free electrons are there in the conductor. So free electrons experience attractive force towards the positive phase of the conductor. Okay. Due to this attractive force, the electrons are drifted towards the positive phase of the conductor. Okay. And now we know that the drift velocity of the free electrons is Vd equal E capital E upon M into tau, where E is the charge on an electron, capital E is the electric field, M is the mass of one electron and tau is the relaxation time. Okay, if E, on putting the value of E in this equation, from this equation, here Vd will be E V upon L upon M into tau, or Vd will be equal E V upon M L into tau. Okay, this is the drift velocity. Now, electrons are drifted towards this positive phase. Electrons are moving, means here charge, electrons are charged particle. That's why here charge is moving. When charge is moving, here electric current is developed. Okay, so the electric current flowing through the conductor is I equal E N A V D, where E is the charge on an electron, N, small n is the number of free electrons per unit volume, capital A is the cross sectional area, and Vd is the drift velocity. Okay, on putting the value of Vd from this equation, I will be E N A into E V upon M L into tau, or I will be equal N E square, N E square tau into A into V upon M L. Okay. Now, or V upon I, on transferring the value M L in this side, the M L will be in the place, M L will be here, ML upon in the denominator, N E square tau into A, ML in the numerator and N E square tau A in the denominator. Okay, now this is the value. Now M, mass of electron, that is constant. L, length of the conductor, that is also constant. Here small n is the number of free electrons per unit volume, that is also constant. Okay, now E is the charge of an electron, that is constant. Tau is the relaxation time. For a particular temperature, tau is fixed. So that is also constant. Capital A is the cross-sectional area, that is also constant for same conductor. So these values are all the constant. These all the values are constant. So that's why these values can be replaced by another constant. So here V upon I, another constant, let that is R, capital R. So in the conductor where current is made to flow through the conductor, then R is called the resistance of the conductor. Okay, now V equal R into I. R is constant, so this equation can be written as V proportional I. And we know that the Ohm's law is, according to the Ohm's law, when potential difference is applied across the terminals of the conductor, and if the physical condition like the temperature, pressure and the mechanical strain do not change, then the current flowing through the conductor is directly proportional to the potential difference applied across the terminals of the conductor. So here is the same relation. Current is flowing through the conductor is directly proportional to the applied potential difference. So we got here the Ohm's law. That is Ohm's law. This is the constant. And the value R is equal to here ML upon N E square tau into A. Okay, this is the value of resistance of the conductor. Okay, so we will discuss about the resistance of the conductor later in another video.